The first incident involved the murder of two people by a family member. The victims have been identified as John Chamuhangire, aged 55, and 9-year-old Musinguzi Lawrence, both residents of Kijonjomi village in Isungwa sub-county, Kagadi district. He seemed to love the children and they loved him too. So when he asked that one of them accompanies him, we had no problem with it. But in the morning, we heard the child screaming for help. My husband and I rushed there. By the time we managed to break into the house, he had stabbed the child. I rushed with the child to the hospital, but he died. When my husband tried to disarm his brother, he too was killed. The killer has been living by himself. He never really has food or even bedsheets in his house. He is a strange person. And I've always asked myself how a normal person can live in that house. The suspect is said to have fled the scene after killing his nephew and his own brother. But once residents saw him, they pounced.
We are too sad to see that such a situation wouldn't be controlled by at least the local leadership. We would have actually saved their lives. We see a lot of contestations within the village, within the communities. We would have actually settled this matter had we known it.
When you see what has happened here today, it is as if people are not human. They were burning as if they were burning charcoal, as if they were burning something which is not living. It is so sad. And people were, it was as if they are burning something funny, they were burning a tree. But burning someone, a human being, in this manner, it shows that people are still blind.
Similarly, residents of Mabale A village in Nyakarongo sub-county, Kagadi district, were horrified upon discovering the body of a 45-year-old man dumped alongside a community access road.
This is so unfortunate to the people around this area. This is so unfortunate to the government of Uganda and the leadership. But we are in charge, what I know. We must bring those people to books since we have now got them through videos and very many things and pictures that were took here when they were doing this.
The victim, identified as Matayo Kaza, was a resident of the same area. It is suspected that Kaza was attacked and killed by his son following a dispute over land. Report by Thomas Chumwebaze for the news.